I created a mobile game where you have to find airports on a map. It is called Find the Airport. The app is available for Android and iOS. Links are in the description. I used React Native with Expo to create this app. There is a pretty popular library to use a map in React Native called React Native Maps, but I decided to use a different approach. I used OpenLayers. In this video, I will show you how I did that. Let's go! So first of all, let's answer the question why I did not use React Native Maps and decided to use OpenLayers instead. Well, when I researched which mapping libraries could be considered, React Native Maps was definitely on the shortlist. Active development, good documentation, lots of features. Really good reasons to go for this library. But there was one thing that I did not like that much, and this was the fact that you have to use Google Maps for Android or Google Maps / Apple Maps for iOS, because I wanted to have the possibility to only show GeoJSON data in the map without any other base map. As I already had some experience in OpenLayers, it actually was a no-brainer for me to use it for my mobile app. OpenLayers is a very popular mapping library for the web, which gives you plenty of possibilities to show maps in a web app. But this leads us already to one potential downside of OpenLayers in React Native. The library is made for web applications. It is based on JavaScript and HTML, so there is no way to directly integrate it in React Native. The only way we can do that is to embed a browser control in our app, which shows a website that hosts our map. The first step was to create an OpenLayers project, simply by following the quick start guide. This creates you a folder structure like this. This folder can be opened with a code editor like VS Code. The initial example already contains a full screen map with an OpenStreetMap layer in it. We can start the project via npm start and open the page in the browser, which brings us this full screen map. Next, I integrated a GeoJSON file that contains a feature that represents the United States to make the map a bit more interesting and to see what is possible. I also customized the styling a bit so the border of the feature is red and the fill style is also a red that is half transparent. The result looks like this. An OpenStreetMap layer and on top a GeoJSON layer that shows the United States. Awesome! But how would all this look like inside in mobile app? To find this out, we have to do some things. First, we have to create a HTML file of this OpenLayers project, which we will integrate in our app. To achieve this, I first installed another npm package called vplugin single file, which allows us to create one single HTML file that contains the JavaScript and the CSS content too, so we just need to integrate this single file in our app. We have to specify this plugin in the vt configuration file. Then we just start the build command, which will create our HTML file in the dist folder of our project. And as we can see, this file contains the HTML, the JavaScript code, and the CSS stylings. Now it is time to create the React Native project. I decided to go for Expo, and so I used the create Expo app command with a TypeScript template, which creates a blank Expo project. This results in a folder structure like this. We also open this folder in VS Code. The first thing to do here is to install a new npm package called React Native WebView. We will also need the possibility to handle files in our app, so we also install the Expo Asset package. Now let's take the HTML file we created before and place it in the Assets folder of our app. To show the OpenLayers map in the app, one created a new component simply called Map. This component is pretty simple, because all we do here is to load the content of our HTML file and show it in the web view. To load the HTML content, we use the assets hook that we get from the Expo asset package we installed before. We specify our HTML file here. With the effect hook, we then load the content of the file and set it to a state variable. When the state variable with our HTML file content is set, we can show the web view. We can simply use the WebView component from the React Native WebView package and set some props. The most important one is the source prop, where we have the possibility to set the page the WebView should show. The other props are to set the width and height of the WebView, to enable JavaScript and disable scrolling and scaling, which would affect the map behavior. In the app component, we simply use the map component, so it will be shown full screen. Now let's see how this looks like when we start the app. We just execute the npm start command, which gives us the possibility to open the app on the Expo Go app on the smartphone. and that's our result. The map is shown full screen in the app, and we can use the map just as we did before in the browser. We see the OpenStreetMap base layer and our GeoJSON content on top. Works like a charm. This all looks really good already, but there is one important thing missing, because at the moment, this is a simple static map. We can zoom and pan on the map, rotate it and watch the contents of the map, but often you'll want to be able to let the app communicate with the map. For example, you want to zoom to a certain position in the map, or you want to send events from the map to the app. This is pretty easy to realize. First, we switch back to the OpenLayers project and go to the main.js file again. At the end of the file, we add two things. Firstly, we add a new function on the window object, I call it zoom to GeoJSON. This function can be called from the React Native app and does nothing more than zooming to the extent of the GeoJSON file. Then we add a click event handler on the map object, which invokes a function in the React Native app and sends the tapped position of the map. Our app will then show the position in an alert modal. Then we build the project again and copy the resulting HTML file to the assets folder of our React Native app. In the map component of our React Native app, we also have to change some things. Number one is to give the component some props, an uninitialized function that expects a callback function and an onMapPress function that expects the coordinates of the pressed position. We define a ref for the WebView component via the ref hook and connect it with the WebView. In the effect hook, where we set the loaded HTML file content, we call the uninitialized function of the props and pass a function of the component which does nothing more than call the zoom to GeoJSON function we defined before in the OpenLayers page. The message handler function is to react on events that are sent from the web page. Here we parse the data that is sent, which is the coordinate in our case, and call the onMapPress function from the props with the coordinate. We set this function to the onMessageProp of the WebView component. Now we are almost done, we just have to switch to the app component where we have to specify the props of the map component. We pass a function for the uninitialized prop that takes the zoom function and stores it on a ref. We also pass a function for the onMapPress prop. This function takes the coordinate and displays it in an alert box. And finally, we create a button under the map, which calls the stored zoom function of the ref when it is pressed. Let's launch the app again to see how it looks now. We have the button at the bottom of the screen, and when we press it, the map zooms to the extent of the GeoJSON data source. And when we tap anywhere on the map, we see an alert box showing us the position of the tap. And that's the magic. I think this is a pretty convenient way to work with maps in React Native. It takes a few steps to make it work, but the result is worth it. So what do you think? Would you consider using OpenLayers in React Native, perhaps in the way I showed in this video? Or would you take a different approach? Let me know in the comments, I am really interested in your opinion. If you are interested in the example project I showed in this video, you can find it on GitHub, the link to the repo is in the description. That brings us to the end, thank you for watching, feel free to subscribe to the channel if you want to keep seeing videos like this from me. See you next time.